Sir, I think I changed. I did some couple of changes in my presentation, sir. So now I change my perspective after listening to my chairman, sir, so many times because, you know, I'm learning. You know, I'm younger than him and, you know, learning a lot from my chairman, sir. So I see now the India became a land of opportunities. I think, you know, this is what the India is as of now. I mean, you know, we need to thank to COVID pandemic also because every country in the world started looking towards our country as a production house as well as a 1.4 billion users. So this customer base with an amazing thing called democracy, you know, which they don't find in countries like China. So now they are taking this advantage and started investing in our country and started producing so many products. So in order to do that, first we need to employ our students. We need to prepare them, right? So we have taken a couple of initiatives and I'm going to cover internship, employability, innovation, and entrepreneurship side. And the one of the thing is, as you know, India is a youthful nation with highly skilled workers. I mean, you know, we produced millions of workers. If you go to any country in the world, you will find a professional and they are, you know, Indians. And if you see any vice presidents or CTOs or CEOs of most biggest companies, they are Indians. And the kind of adaptation of technology is really amazing. I mean, if you see in a couple of villages in America, you know, they are much, you know, they are not such advanced like in India. And now we are adopted 3G, now we adopted 4G Volt. I mean, with the help of 4G Volt, we are almost watching the videos and transferring the knowledge from one place to another place with high quality content without any buffering. What it really means is we have that kind of adaptation in our mind. And now we are even ready to adopt 5G technologies. And after 5G technologies, I'm sure India will become a superpower because we have that capability of doing a think tank and we have capability of doing jugaad. This kind of a combination is very rare in the rest other countries and which we have. And another very important key ingredient for success in 21st century is trust. The entire globe, every country and every industry, they are looking towards us and we are a trustworthy human beings in the globe. So the investments are pouring into our country. In last 6 years, we have received more than $310 billion US dollars as inflows. It means huge investments are happening. So those most of the companies already establishing their bases and they have started producing and they started producing recently. And during the COVID pandemic, we have received more than $74 billion. I mean, huge investments, which if you compare with the previous sessions, which is 20% more than what we received. What it really means is we are moving from a knowledge-based society to a superpower society. You know, that's where we are moving towards. And as you already know, we have the third highest number of internet users with a consumer base of 1.4 billion. And our daily density is 92.84%. And the India's youth is the world's largest youth-based country with 64% is between 15 to 34 years. And this demography is going to mean a lot of benefit to our country. And growth in technology is like India, the whole India became a digital hub. Recently, I visited one of the small village in remote village in Andhra Pradesh to for one of the marriage, and trust me, the way the internet is working there, like in a super fast mode, and I have attended an online session and I have shared my screen from the one of the smallest remote area in Andhra Pradesh, and I'm able to successfully finish my presentation. Then I realized the kind of a technological upgradation, you know, happening in our country is going to become a digital hub for the entire world. So the entire digital talent is also residing in our country, and that the kind of a technological growth is really taking us forward. And the consumer story, if you see, we have more than 129 million urban mass consumers. And I'm sure after the COVID pandemic, it may reach somewhere around 200 million, which is a huge number. And 400 billion is what we invested in our infrastructure market. So with respect to roads, or with respect to national highways, with respect to port upgradation, etc. So what it really means is it is generating so many employment opportunities and giving opening up opportunities for our entrepreneurs as well as researchers. And along with that, there is a new thing called food. Because what is happening is previously the world used to call a oil-based society, right? The entire globe. So now slowly as the entire world is moving towards renewable energy and solar energy, so now the food is occupied, you know, after the technology. So in India, in last 6 years, we have created more than 42 mega food parks and 228 cold chain facilities and 100 food labs. What it really means is we are going to not only preserve the food and, you know, we can have more, you know, economy from the food point of view. So that is another ingredient and a kind of initiatives we have taken on the Make in India process. And we have received investments on auto components, automobiles, aviation, biotechnology, chemicals, food processing, IT, BPM, leather, medium, railways, roads, highways, renewable energy. I mean, you know, various sectors. So these all sectors are getting, you know, pushed up in a very, you know, in a rapid phase, which is going to result more than 10 crore direct and 40 crore indirect opportunities by 2024. So the real challenge is now the opportunities are ready, and the opportunities are ready for not only for our students, it's the opportunities are ready for our entrepreneurs and for researchers. And recently there's another amazing thing happened is with the help of this Make in India process, the France offered to move their entire assembly line of their Panther choppers, Rafale jet fighters, the twin engine light combat aircrafts and advanced medium combat air force. So what it really means is that not only within India, entire globe is started believing a Make in India and Made in India process. So this is going to, because of this kind of a technological upgradation, so this is helping us on that side. And India is launching the world's biggest coronavirus vaccination program. I mean, see from the minute we started in 1962, the industrialization 2.0, India as well as China both started at the same time, but China moved forward with help of industrial 2.0 and 3.0. But now it's a industry 4.0 is coming up, and India is the one which picked up the thing. And now we are taking things forward. And amazingly, 19 nations reached out to us for making India COVID vaccine. So what it really means is the entire world is recognizing India as a superpower now. I think now we need to take things forward, but at the same time, we need to make sure our employability issue will get resolved. And we not only produce the job seekers, we will produce the job givers. So that's where, you know, I'm going to move towards. So there is lots of investments are happening from the government point of view. If you see the critical infrastructure sectors like banking services, financial, food, energy sectors, energy grids, we are interconnecting all energy grids, data and cloud side, space, educational side, transportation, communication. There are 6,835 projects are listed, and in government of India invested more than 111 lakh crore on national critical infrastructure. And recently, if you see, we spent 40,000 crore rupees on the upgradation of Paradip port. What it really means is, you know, the kind of a port base, the number one infrastructure from a port point of view is China. So now we are coming up with the upgradation of a ports so that we can have a better supply chain management as well as logistics. So we are investing a lot of money. What it means is lots of opportunities basically created by the government itself. And in the recent sessions, there are more than 1,000 foreign manufacturing firms. They started, their firms moved towards India. They said bye-bye, China, and you know, they come up to India. And one of the biggest organizations is setting up in Bengaluru. They are putting an iPhone plant. I mean, you know, the entire end-to-end development of iPhone phones. So imagine the kind of a market and the kind of employment opportunities, the kind of a research opportunities, the kind of a entrepreneurial opportunities, the kind of a logistical based opportunities, supply chain based opportunities, and the indirect based opportunities going to create. I mean, India is becoming a global hub for producing all kind of electronic based devices. Because you know, we are pretty good in IoT, I mean, sorry, on IT, BPO, KPO side. So now we are slowly moving towards the IoT side, creating digital twins, creating, you know, using artificial intelligence, business intelligence, and creating lots of cyber security based experts, etc., which I will explain in further. So the developing countries like USA, Japan, France, Germany, Singapore, all these countries are moving towards us, and you know, they are investing in our country for a better return of investment, because one side we have resources, the other side our government provided the best of the best infrastructure for them. And it's a democratic country. That's a beautiful thing, you know, what we have, which others don't have. And the Industry 4.0 is going to create more than 9 crore job opportunities in next 5 to 10 years' time. And in the augmented reality space, big data space, cloud computing, on the predictive analytics, cyber security side, I mean, you know, it's a huge opportunity for Indians, because Indians have that jugaad of understanding both, and we are pretty good in mathematics. So till now, what was happening is, if you see from the banking point of view, if you take an example, we have more than 5 crore ATMs in India. But most of the ATM physical devices was manufactured in China or in Taiwan or other countries. So now we are having those manufacturing hubs in India itself. So with the help of this Industry 4.0 technologies, we are not only towards the artificial intelligence side, we are even interacting and creating those IoT related devices and started doing both production at the same time. So this is one of the mass generation opportunity for India to move forward. And lots of automotive opportunities, it's more than 1.5 crore opportunities. As you know, internet vehicles are completely taken over the automotive industry. Because in order to create one automobile, example car, if you take, there are a lot of smaller components which you need to create. And all these components needs to be get interconnected with Internet of Vehicles technology. And they are using the advanced technologies like V2V and V2I. And the actual real engine may be getting built in Germany or somewhere. But we have the digital twin of the same copy, and the lots of firms started working on those digital twins, and they started doing lots of, you know, creating the sensors and using a big data analytics and implementing the one of the best advanced, most advanced electrification in India. So all these kind of opportunities are in our country. And the financial service, as you all know, that, you know, the India is a financial basis services. So I will just skip this a faster mode. So we are more moving towards a mobile based as well as regtech called, you know, and blockchain based. And so the biotech is another opportunity we are getting on the synthetic biology, metabolic engineering, nanomedicine. Huge opportunity. If you see one of the medical park which we established in Visakhapatnam, it used to be almost empty, you know, a few years back I have seen. But in last 4 years I have observed, it's very difficult to discuss. What it really means is, we are the one who is producing the medical components, the like syringes, or, you know, the one which we are using it for to prevent corona. All these kind of things are getting produced in our country in a mass way. It is resulting a mass employment in our country. And 3D bioprinting, gene editing, mixed reality, and lots of operations nowadays, what doctors are doing is, they are doing a virtual operation, and then they are doing a real operation. So see the power of the technology and the way we as Indians using this technology forward. And tissue engineering, as you already know, as I already spoke about food technology. So now we are concentrating on food safety and delivery of food and how we can reduce the food wastage. I mean, lots of expenditure happened in this, but trust me, in next few years, and because of this new agriculture policy, it's a win-win situation for the farmer, because he will get a better produce and he will get a better profits, and he can store his produce in cold storages as well as in food parks for very less price. So we are coming up with, you know, very advanced. So this is another opportunities for all entrepreneurs to create lots of solutions on top of it. And similarly for healthcare side, as you know, 3D imaging, Internet of Medical Things, it's really dominating the entire healthcare. And now if you see the most of the Indian healthcare chains, they are getting funds from various countries because they strongly believe they have their customer base here in India. At the same time, they can produce the internet medical things here for a cheaper price and they can sell it to the entire globe. And India became kind of a marketing hub also for them. And this is another opportunity from the energy side. We have more than 30 lakh job opportunities in energy sector. If you see, we already have a smart meters implemented in place. Microgrid is getting connected. But the beauty is the renewable energy side. We became a world second most producible renewable energy in the world. But Chinese is number one. As you know, no one remembers number two. I think we want to make sure we are moving towards number one. IITs and they all are working very hard on this. And they're coming with lots of technological innovations where we push ourselves towards a number one in this particular area. Storage of renewable energy is also increased. And agri as well as telecommunication side, with the help of these new technologies like the next gen mobile networking called 5G and network functions virtualization, with help of these two M2M technologies, we are going to rule this world, in the next, coming years. So along with these opportunities, what government did, there's a fundamental difference between the ex-Prime Minister Manmohan Singh's government and our current Honorable Prime Minister Modi's government. We are giving incentive based on the production-linked incentive. The more you produce, the more incentive you receive. What it really means is we are encouraging them to create more opportunities for our students, for our entrepreneurs, etc. And at the same time, on the MSME side, if you see, we have given a relaxation to all the new startups and entrepreneurs so that they can do a tendering process without paying the security deposit. Because as you know, in the government, you need to pay a security deposit. That is discouraging our entrepreneurs and startups. So we have given away that option and we are relaxed that option. So now any company, any entrepreneur or any serial startup or a startup, they can submit government tenders without paying even 1 rupee. And so what it really means is we are going to have 50 crore plus opportunities by 2025. But is our students ready? Because it's not only about getting an opportunity. It is are they workplace ready? Are they ready for innovation? So we have identified a couple of technologies, job roles, skills, we have identified. And we started giving training on this particular skills. And how we have transforming, because now I talked about the kind of a requirements we are receiving, not only in India, in the entire world, we have understood what industry wants. And with help of these advanced technologies, we are fine-tuning all our educational policies to skill and upskill the students for their better future. This is what the entire education policy is all about. I mean, you don't need to read those 600 pages. So basically, this beauty of the national education policy, it's agile in nature. So it has that kind of a flexibility. It takes the input and it adopts. And with the help of these advanced technologies, we are fine-tuning. We are ready to fine-tune. We will learn from you and we will give the best, only the best to our students as well as to the institute. So with the help of this new education policy, as sir has already covered most of the new education policy things. So I'm just skipping some of the slides here. So the thing is, what's happening in our country is, because of the old education policy, the students as well as entrepreneurs, everyone become isolated in nature. They are working in isolation way. So now with help of a new education policy, they understand, they work together as a team, as a collaboration. And the learning is not like a rote methodology. We are going to have a play-based, discovery-based learning. And developing the curiosity is very, very important, because I asked 1,000 questions to my chairman, sir, because unless until I understand fully, I will keep on asking, because developing the curiosity, asking, logically thinking and solving that problem, in a logical way, and aim to be more creative on the other side. So these are the amazing elements which we have put in, and I see one of the best thing happened after our independence of our, because this is kind of a path-breaking initiative which we have taken in the name of new education policy. This is going to change not only our country, this is going to create one of the best country, for the entire globe. So I'm just moving towards a higher education due to lack of time. So as I mentioned earlier, we are not only creating millions of job seekers, now we want to create a job creator. So that is where the entrepreneurs, innovation, research comes into picture. So the new education policy has all those ingredients in place, which I will extend in further slides. So we are using, holistic multidisciplinary education, which sir has already explained, and multiple entry, multiple exit. All these are giving a flexibility, a freedom of taking a decision. You know, that's a beauty of our country. So we are giving that freedom. And on the professional education side, we are concentrating on recent graduates and trying to train them. And we are targeting more than 40 crore students, faculty, as well as recent graduates to get upgradation of their skills. And promoting multilingualism is another one of the major point in the national education policy side. And we are using an advanced technologies nowadays. If you see, the textbooks got transformed towards a video and interactive audio as well as PDF modes. And we are using AR, VR technologies, 3D technologies, artificial intelligence, blockchain, data-driven, 34 DTH channels which we have started. So all are free. You can go to Google and you can search, example, advanced chemistry, MHRD, DTH channel, you will get that channel. And everything is free and high quality content. We have taken lots of such initiatives, for the students. And one of the initiatives is for the internship side, based on the Honorable Prime Minister's target, we have created an internship portal where we are providing more than 1 crore internship opportunities by 2025. So here we have identified all the stakeholders from the government side, from the corporate side, from the MSME side, from NGO startups and research internships. And what happens is if you want to work for any organization, so this is a very well-crafted, beautifully designed website which we have created. So the students can come here and they can apply for the internship opportunities. Either they can search on the top or you have on a city-based, you will see all the list and you can click on your favorite city or nearby city and you can apply for an internship opportunity. And this application loads the minute you do like this. I mean, you can even test it. It's called internship.aict-india.org. And this was developed by the students just to make sure that, our students are the best students in the world. So this application, if you value this application with any venture capitalist, this is going to value up to $500 million. So this kind of an amazing application which we have created, and this has more than 90,000 plus internship opportunities in place. And it loads super fast like this, as I'm sharing. It may taking a minute for you to see, but it loads information in a very much faster way. It basically loading more than 40 to 50,000 results in less than 7 to 8 seconds. So that's the way we have built this entire application. Let's quickly go back to my presentation. So there's another initiative called NEET, where we are bringing all the best of the best edtech companies in one place, and we are enabling them socially and economically deployed section. So these are another portal called NEET where we have initiated. And at the time of COVID pandemic, we have created one free resources for the digital content. So 43 best of the best tech companies offered their content for free of cost on this portal. And I'm happy to share that more than 246 crore worth of content it was distributed for free of cost to more than 13.9 lakh students. So this is again free. It's called free.aact-india.org, where we have all those things in place. So research point of view, we are about to start a national research foundation, because as you see from the innovation and research side, we in the previous education policy, we never encouraged any student from that side. And the encouragement is very less. And if you see, the intellectual property submissions are less than 2%, which is very, very less. So we want to increase that number. So the National Research Foundation basically helps you to get a funding for your research and getting a mentorship and creating a doctoral and postdoctoral fellowships here and creating the not only on the verticals of science and technology, we want to go with the social sciences, arts, humanities, etc. And government, we are going to help the students from the national research point of view. And innovation is another thing, which is very, very crux. And you need to be a number one in all aspects, not only from producing an idea, you need to turn that idea into a product and do marketing and sales and you will have a funneling system where you can generate money. You need to do a due diligence. So we have come up with a portal called Yukti. So on the Yukti, what we are doing is we are encouraging every student as well as the startups, the institutes, everyone can come together and they can submit their startup details here, and we will help them. If you come down and see the work, a couple of opportunities we have here, which is already posted. So some of, you know, someone shared a initiative called contactless waste bin, you know, and we are doing lots of, you know, initiatives. So all those innovation ideas was published here, and various sectors, if you see, from aviation to agriculture to clean tech to consumer goods, conventional energy, defense and sector, education, electronics, IoT, fashion, textiles. So we are ready to help every entrepreneur in India who is studying, who is in college. And we even encouraging the institute to be part of this initiative along with your students and faculty. So what it means is the institute, the faculty, as well as students, they all can come together. And we are ready to invest, and we are ready to connect you to the funders. We are ready to help you on the due diligence and various other processes we have. So this is the amazing portal which we have created. If you go to on the resources page, you will see all kind of a resources we have and how we are going to help you here. I mean, there's a step-by-step process what we have created. So the pre-incubation and role of networking, how we are going to help you on the networking side, and hang out with other successful startup founders, and how you can create a best of the best design, because UX is the dominating nowadays. The more user interface you have, the more sellability you will get. And your application needs to be faster, at the same time mobile compatible. So we are ready to help you to connect to the experts in the society. At the same time, we are ready to help you on fine-tuning your business idea and connecting you to enable and do an intellectual property for your early stage innovations and startups, and understanding the angel as well as venture capitalism, because as most of the startups, you know, they need to go with the angel investment. And the process of entire due diligence on the angel investment is completely different than a venture capital funding. Because the venture capital funding, where they expect a 20x, but an angel investor, you know, they expect the outcome is completely different. And sometimes you may receive an angel investor who wants not only spend these financials, he wants to spend his time and energy and his expertise also. So we are here and ready to help all our entrepreneurs and startups. And I mean, you know, student startups who can come to us, and we are ready to help them on all these processes. And obviously the legal and ethical steps and you know, on the funding side also, of course. So these are the steps, and very well built and very beautifully designed, very simple to use portal which we have created for our students. And the registration is also free, and it's very simple. If you go to yukti.mic.gov.in, so you will see, if you're a student, you register here, faculty can register here, staff, institute can register here. And what we encourage is, as we said, you know, now we are in a new 21st century. See, the students are the best of the best, they have the best knowledge. But institute has an infrastructure. Why don't you become one of the partner in the enterprise and in the startup of the student idea and facilitate them, and your faculty can guide them. See, someone is asking how we can increase the entrepreneurial thoughts in our faculty. The best things are, if you ask me, try to identify the industry problems, speak with the industries, take that as a challenge, and start working with your students and build those solutions. And please come to us. We are here to help from an ideation point of view too. If you have any product which is ready to go, we are ready to help, and we will help in a way that you will get a win-win situation for you, as well as for the government. Because what we strongly feel is in India, we are going to get lots of unicorns in a very recent, in the next few years. So that's where we see the energy. Just give me 1 second. I have two more slides to show. So this is a national innovation, which we already have gone through. So I'm just skipping on that side. So the entrepreneurship side, you know, I'm really a bit worried, because the number of entrepreneurship, if you take in our country, This total is 5.8 crores. And this is only 5%, the lowest rate in the world. And the while the business discontinuity rate is very high, it is 26.4%. And only 13% women entrepreneurs are there. So, sir, I request, sir, for every college, if you have any student, irrespective of their gender, please encourage them to do some kind of entrepreneurship activity. And the major problem in our society is fear of failure. I think, you know, this is where we are encouraging. We are saying one simple word is, don't worry if you fail, you know, the world won't stop. It's an opportunity to learn how not to fail. So sometimes when I fail, you know, I take it in a positive way and try to, you know, motivate myself so that the learning opportunity is already finished. So your risk of, you already mitigated your risk. So success factor will increase, the ratio of success will increase, which will result that stagnant economy of our country will convert into a vibrant economy. And the poverty and inequality will get eradicated or get at least reduced. So we have identified few key interest areas, and as I already demonstrated about Yukti. So the final thought process is that you, for the every entrepreneur, is it's okay to fail. I mean, you know, you don't feel that, you know, you are failing and you will get disconnected to the society. We are there to help you. If you fail in one process, we already have so many other entrepreneurs and startups ready. Maybe if you fit into that, you know, we will add you as one of the team member, or maybe as a co-inventor. So don't worry, you please invent what all you want to do. If you want to start something, you know, you start, irrespective whether you're in a first year or second year or final year of your college. And by saying that, my name is Buddha Chandrasekhar. I'm a chief coordinating officer. And my thought process always was to empower our students and faculty with help of the advanced technologies. So, andarki namaskaram. Thank you.